Kyle Rittenhouse is back in the news because he needs your money. This guy who has attempted to make an identity and a career out of the fact that when he was 17 years old, he brought an AR-15 style rifle to a protest in Kenosha and killed some people. Now says that his legal fees are getting too high, and so you guys need to bail him out again. He tweeted, "I am being sued again by Gaige, one of the families involved in the shooting, the Huber family now as well. The legal bills are piling up, and I need your help. You can donate by going to blah blah blah. I don't care, and I'm not going to tell you because you shouldn't donate that." But anyway, he says this lawsuit is an attempt to drown anyone who legally and justifiably defends their misspelled lives from attackers in a mountain of legal debt. We cannot let them win. If they can come after me, they will come after you. Well, I just want to reassure you, I don't think they're going to come after you because you, dear viewer, probably didn't go and kill some people. So I feel like you're probably fine. They came after him because he did go and kill some people. He was very happy to kill some people. He went prepared to kill some people. And now he's trying to make literally the only reason anyone would pay attention to him, the fact that he already killed some people. The fact that as a result of him killing people, he is suffering from some legal debt feels more like his problem than our problem, Jessica. But what do you think?
I think it's absurd. I mean, he should have considered that we live in a very litigious society. Maybe think about that before you go to a protest with the clear intent of being an adversary to the people who are in the majority who are protesting. Everybody knows why Kyle Rittenhouse left his house with his gun that night. It's very obvious. He got lucky the first time around getting a judge that intentionally confused the jury about how they were supposed to decide on the case. If you watch the footage of what went down in the courtroom, it's ridiculous, but you can't always get a corrupt judge that's on your side. You're probably going to be sued by other people who are there, and you can't really bank on that. And the fact that he has such high legal fees, he has private attorneys. What's wrong with our public defenders, Kyle Rittenhouse? You don't think you'd get a fair trial with them? Is that what's going on here? Interesting.
By the way, I'm glad that you mentioned the bias in the trial. Also, bear in mind the judge was like going on the news. Like we're talking about the forewoman in Fulton County, but he was talking all like about how bad he felt for Kyle Rittenhouse and everything. So yeah, that was a sham. We do have this other case though, and I want to give you a little bit of details about it because you might be wondering, well, if he got off the first time, if they said that what he did was legal, if wildly immoral, intentionally so, how are they having another case? Well, here's what is going on. So it was initially fired by Anthony Huber's father, John Huber, back in 2021. It draws a link between Rittenhouse's actions and those of law enforcement present at the scene of the protest. They accuse Kenosha police officers of allowing a dangerous situation that violated his son's constitutional rights and resulted in his death. Also alleging that Rittenhouse, who claimed that he acted in self-defense and was not found guilty of murder back in 2021, conspired with officers to harm protesters. So look, I'm not on their legal team. I hope that goes without saying. But the basic idea is he and other people are marching around with guns that they have no reason to have there unless they intend to shoot someone with an incredible jovial relationship with the police who are giving him water. And after he shoots people, he just gets to walk away with his AR-15 from the site of a shooting. There seemed to be coordination, at least in some fashion, between them. I'll leave it to the legal proceeding to figure out exactly what that is. But they're not simply suing just because he killed people, but because of the environment that was created by law enforcement leading up to the killings. Any thoughts, Jessica?
What an interesting quote. The part where they say the police officers allowed this situation to take place. There have been so many Supreme Court cases where police officers have not prevented crime when they were aware that there was a present threat or something could be going on and they should be investigating because a crime was about to take place. And time and again, the Supreme Court has ruled that they only have a responsibility to, you know, detain people after a crime has been committed. So this idea that the police were somehow responsible by allowing the scene to happen, it's probably not going to hold up in court.
Yeah, I sort of worry about that. And it's really the added layer of injustice is that if that does happen and it takes years, it's going to ruin a couple years of Kyle Rittenhouse's life and make him pay for, it's terrible that that's happening. I feel really bad. Anyway, by the way, people have given over $100,000 to him.
Gross.
That is madness. Like, do you have nothing going on? You don't have friends or family that's strong with anything that could use Like, people are giving someone they have never met money so that they can deal with the legal fallout from their choice to kill some people. What a weird way to spend your money. While I'm not going to give you the link to donate to him, Bay Photo does have a suggestion, a super chat that says Kyle should unsub from Twitter Blue, save $8 a month. Because of course he is actually subscribed under Twitter Blue. I noticed that as well.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.